treated for relapsed refractory myeloma in third line or a challenge. And patients who are in this setting who are older, say over 75, it's even more of a challenge. Pomalidomide has been faithfully present in third line, helping these patients. But we've always thought that a combination type therapy, particularly a triplet type therapy, using pomalidomide would be the best way to go. In this paper, the investigators looked at older patients who were treated on the Icaria MM trial. And this was a trial that compared a triplet, isatuximab, pomalidomide, and dexamethasone to pomalidomide and dexamethasone. Isatuximab was administered at 10 milligrams per kilogram weekly for the first cycle and then every 2 weeks going forward. Pomalidomide was administered at 4 milligrams for days 1 to 21, and dexamethasone was given either 40 milligrams or 20 milligrams for patients 75 years and older. The Icaria trial demonstrated that the primary endpoint was PFS, and the Icaria trial demonstrated overall superior PFS for patients receiving the isatuximab pomalidomide dex triplet. Moreover, in the older patients, those 75 and older, the PFS benefit was even greater, and the 11.5 months noted in the entire group was also noted in the older patients, and that was compared to just 4.4 months in the PD arm. That gave a hazard ratio of about 0.49 and statistical benefit. Treatment emergent adverse events were higher in the older patients, but in both arms. And that included anemia, thrombocytopenia, and in some cases, pneumonia. In the end, the investigators concluded that the combination of isatuximab, pomalidomide, and dex resulted in superior overall response rates, superior PFS, and better survival. And so this becomes an excellent option, specifically for older patients, where it seems quite tolerable with excellent clinical efficacy. It is a challenging group, the in third line or beyond. I would add that these patients on this trial had to have had at least two prior therapies and had to be double exposed to both an IMiD and PI. So this historically has been a very difficult population to treat with limited efficacy. So the fact that we've seen a strong signal of clinical benefit is very important. How this will work in Canada has yet to unfold. Obviously, isatuximab is the second monoclonal antibody to come into the market. It seems to work very well with pomalidomide. This seems like a great option for these patients, even older ones. So how ultimately, whether we use isatuximab in second line or as it's studied in this trial in third line, will yet to be determined.